Hey there, Washington football team fans. I am your host, Tom Downing, here to keep you guys updated with what's going on around your favorite NFL team. On today's video, we're taking a look at whether or not Washington is a top four team in the NFC East. ESPN's Dan Orlovsky, who doesn't like the Cowboys but loves the football team quite a bit, he's hyping up Washington this year. Now, the football team's coming off a win of the NFC East last season, and I was very impressed by how well they competed against the eventual Super Bowl champions. There's no disagreement that they have the defense. Offense, a bit of a question mark. Despite that, these are the top four teams for Dan Orlovsky in the NFC entering this season. Tampa Bay, they're number one. I get that. I really do. No surprise, right? The Rams are number two. He's a big Matthew Stafford guy. The Arizona Cardinals are curiously number three, and then Washington makes the list at number four. Now, I wanted to compare Orlovsky's list here with the current odds to simply make the playoffs, right? Which does factor in divisions more so than pure Super Bowl odds do. The Bucs and Rams, no surprise, they're the betting favorites there. Tampa, whew, minus 560, absolutely massive at that one. Then it's the Rams. Then the 49ers, you guys won't like the number four team there, the Dallas Cowboys, but remember, it's the Cowboys. Their odds are always boosted there. The Seahawks are actually the number three NFC West team over Arizona. Then you get to the not favorites, the teams with plus odds here, i.e. you're making money on a $10 bet in terms of you put 10 down, you'll get extra money, $11.40 for the Saints. Vikings, Washington actually checks in all the way down at number seven on the odds to make the playoffs. The Bears and then the Cardinals down there. So the two outlier teams there are Washington and Arizona. I think in the end, a lot of the football team's success is going to be on the shoulders of their quarterback, who I think we all assume will be Ryan Fitzpatrick. Now, last year for Miami in a very unique and I would almost argue odd situation, Fitzpatrick was impressive. His QBR was awesome. He led a lot of comeback situations for Miami as the closer, if you will, to Tua being the starter. But he is Ryan Fitzpatrick. The cycle of Fitzpatrick is he impresses it in a backup role, gets to be the starter, struggles as a starter, loses that starting job, goes to be a great backup, impresses, and it continues on and on. If the defense plays the way we all expect it to, which, again, I think it will, it's going to be on the offense. Can Fitzpatrick and Curtis Samuel and Terry McLaurin and Antonio Gibson and a revamped offensive line, can they be enough to do something that has not been done since 2004, namely repeat as NFC East champions? What do you guys think here? Get your votes in for me right now in the comments section. Will Washington make the playoffs? It's Y for yes or N for no. Get your votes in right now.